Hello and welcome to VPodcast. Technology has advanced much, and today we have access to a million different platforms that keep us aware, informed, entertained, and intellectually engaged. It is possible for us to watch, listen, participate, contribute to, and create information across a wide range of media of expression. We have at our fingertips and on our screens news, films, documentaries, series, tutorials, instructional videos, documents, spreadsheets, and softwares and applications that perform pure magic. But what has the power to transport us to completely different worlds and holds the potential to sharpen our linguistic capabilities, imaginative prowess, and enhance our knowledge of everything has always been and will always remain books. This lockdown, as we stay indoors, why don't we choose a favorite corner at home, perk up the lighting, settle into a comfortable chair or sofa, and decide to live the lives of different characters crafted with much care by writers? Let us listen to Dr. G.P. Bhaskaran, Assistant Professor, Department of English, as she takes us on a journey that will lead us to the world of reading and introduces us to classics we can try.
Hello all. Hope you're doing good and safe in these difficult times. Today, I'm before you to talk about one essential skill that anyone needs to hone while growing up. Yes, I'm speaking about the importance of reading in an individual's life and would like to introduce a few English classics which are easily readable and enjoyable, yet makes you ponder deeply to start with if you have not yet ventured into this overarching domain. What is reading? People often wondered why reading is important when there are many other things that catches one's attention around us. But a deeper probe into this matter will make one realize that reading is the essence of life that will make you think differently from a different perspective. Uniqueness and innovative ideas are always welcomed in any society. People come up with new ideas through contemplation, and any contemplation is the result of a wider reading and its analysis. The often quoted saying, "Pen is mightier than sword," shows the power of word. It has the power to create or destroy. One will be able to distinguish between good and bad ideas only through reading, and can expose the ideas that can destroy the world and propagate the ideas that can build the world further. If one take careless keys into consideration, the current pandemic, which had harvested death even in the developed countries, could not create much impact because of not just the government's overtures, but because of a society which was educated and could make a distinction between what is right and wrong. Those who have not braced themselves with the power of reading could be easily swayed by propagandas and could be exploited. With social distancing becoming the norm, at least for the next few years as envisaged by WHO, the chances of humans, the social animal, to communicate with one another gets restricted. Reading books can give a glimpse of the world and culture you have been otherwise currently barred from visiting and understanding. It expands the horizons and helps one visit strangest places of imagination with conviction. This will be better understood when one slowly takes on the habit. People may often wonder why to read books when the adaptations of many such books into movies are easily available. Movies, however, are the imaginary reflection of the director, while the imaginary world created through reading a book is the creation of the reader. Movies restrict your freedom to think from another perspective as it renders the idea within the limited focus of the screen space, not allowing you to think beyond the imaginary space given by the maker. Reading becomes significant when you want to learn. It becomes significant when you want to escape. However, from the lakhs of books available to us today, it becomes difficult for one to choose the books that they should not miss reading. Here, I'm bringing a list of 5 books which are a must read for reading enthusiasts. The first book I would like to introduce here is George Orwell's Animal Farm. The novella is an allegorical story about the early Soviet Union. First published in England on 17th August 1945, the story is about the life of a group of farm animals who decides to rebel against their human farmer to create a better living environment for all the animals. The story takes a dystopian turn when the self-proclaimed pig leader, Napoleon, becomes the dictator and comments, I quote, "All are equal, but some are more equal than others," unquote. It's considered to be one of the best political allegories which describes what happens when a revolution goes astray. The best part of the story is understood if one knows the history of Russian Revolution. The novella can also be appreciated as a children's story with no understanding of the political message at all. Moving to the second book, Roald Dahl's Charlie and the Chocolate Factory is a children's novel published in 1964. The story features the travel adventures of the young boy Charlie Bucket inside the chocolate factory of Willy Wonka, an eccentric chocolatier. Charlie lives with his 4 grandparents and parents on the edge of a small town in a state of desperate poverty. The novel takes a new turn when Charlie becomes one of the 5 winners of the golden ticket to visit Wonka's chocolate factory. The text unfolds the mysteries of Wonka's chocolate factory, which is one of the strangest but magnificent places. Though the fiction has all the elements of a children's story, where the good boys are rewarded, it stands different with respect to the presence of dark humors, sinister undertone, and playful whimsy. It depicts the darker part of life, including abuses, poverty, and deprivation. One may wonder at the classification of the story under children's story because of these elements. But Roald Dahl does it purposefully, challenging the genre itself. The rationality behind adults representing children is questioned. Also, he problematizes the idea of innocent children and bring in 4 children who are the epitome of sins. The book invokes various kinds of imagination, and the author, with his uncanny knack for making somewhat boring stories sound interesting, made it fascinating and delectable for its readers. Another interesting read is Franz Kafka's best-known work, The Metamorphosis. The story is easily relatable to the present generation as it opens to the reader a metamorphosed world of Gregor Samsa, who one morning wakes up as a gigantic, incredibly disgusting bug. Amidst the COVID-19 lockdown, every single human being, like Gregor, questions the new identity they have formed and questions the existence itself. The novella looks at transformation at multiple levels. The physical transformation of Gregor, the transformation of the loving family to the indifferent family, transformation in their consciousness and existence in the world. One of the best absurd and existential works, this text evokes an individual sense of finding himself victimized by large impersonal forces, feeling after a while that he can't but take it personally, and feeling haunted too by the sense that maybe after all he deserves it. Horror, humor, the trappings of the workday, the surrealism of dreams, all are present right from the first sentence. The fourth book is Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe. The book is a deliberate addition to the group, as it shows the perseverance of human beings. While Kafka's Metamorphosis shows a morbid life, Defoe's Crusoe gives more hope to the people. Defoe's story revolves around the central character, Robinson Crusoe, who, as a young man, defied his parents and went to sea. The novel takes the readers through various adventures taken by Crusoe, who gets shipwrecked and is isolated from the rest of the world in an island. The novel looks at survival from a fresh perspective and also alludes to the worst human sin of being covetous without considering the fellow living beings. The strong determination of a human being to survive in a hostile environment and his overarching quest for travel becomes the theme. The fifth book is The Old Man and the Sea, a short novel written by Ernest Hemingway, the American author. The story centers on an aging Cuban fisherman, Santiago, who engages in an epic battle to catch a giant marlin. A determined Santiago, who has not caught a fish for a long 84 days, decides to go to the deep waters of the Gulf Stream to try his luck. He soon hooks a giant marlin and battles with the fish for 3 days, admiring its strength and its faithfulness to its identity. Though Santiago finally defeats the marlin, his efforts go for a toss when the sharks attack the fish and he is left only with the bone of the fish. The story also revolves around the never-ending human perseverance and the struggle between human and nature. So friends, let us all try to take one baby step at a time into this world of knowledge by slowly plunging into this wide sea of reading. Happy reading.
Thank you, GB ma'am, for introducing these classics to us.